Well, it's possible. I do agree with you that films can influence people. But I do believe that in the horror movies that I make, violence is specifically portrayed to create a feeling of horror from the audience. Unlike some television shows, which do glamorize violence, possibly, and could make it more attractive. Specifically, it's a horror movie because you're afraid of it. And so I disagree with you that this type of picture would make someone want to emulate that type of violence. I know that there is no conclusive study as to the nature of violence on films.
I'm afraid there is.
But gentleman on the
a
front
lot,
row
a lot
has been,
of it in
the gentleman
on
the front
country,
row has been desperate to comment.
Sorry, yeah,
yes.
I mean, the National Viewers List Association is always, they get themselves well into the public eye and they talk, I'm afraid, a lot of rubbish. I'm sorry.
No, rubbish,
I've seen Mr. Raimi's films.
Yeah.
I've written
yeah.
four books on horror movies. I've
yeah.
seen horror movies all my
it's
life.
It's all very well slinging off at the National
Okay,
Viewers
right. Well, you've become
a self.
Let's
see what the effect is in society.
Yeah, it's an effect in society. I've seen enough horror films.
22 times a week. No,
sorry, I've seen enough
one at a time, and then we can hear what you're saying.
Yeah, I've seen enough horror films to last me a lifetime. I happen to enjoy them. I write books about them. I don't believe I've ever seen kids building monsters in basements. I do not believe I've never been attacked by
knives.
A tree. For God's sake, they
and
use
they
knives
use
to cut their knives and
they don't
fork.
Just use Boy Scout knives. Yeah. They're now using butcher's knives
you're
and hunting knives.
But you're suggesting
and
horror films which
and
are
it's
fairy
not
tales for
this
adults.
This is the police in Brixenhurst.
Yeah, but I mean, I think you're confusing things. That's violence.
I didn't think I'm confusing
yeah.
things at
you,
all.
You really think, I mean, have you seen Mr. Raimi's film?
I've seen bits of it, enough of it.
No, you haven't seen
enough. I want to see a great deal more.
If you can show me the person with a knife who's doing a Brixton-style attack, then I might agree.
Go and ask the police in Brixton. They
will
show you.
I don't think the police in Brixton have ever accused Mr. Raimi.
Huge, great knife.
They may not have accused him personally.
Let's have a comment from a few more people in the audience. The gentleman at the back there has got his hand up with the gentleman with the white shirt and the what colour tie is it? Maroon, is it?
It's not so much a case of horror. People going there to be frightened. People go to see these films to get kicks. People live on getting kicks. This is why I agree with the National Viewers and Listeners Association. Not necessarily wholeheartedly, but the whole thing's about kicks. It's the same with all sorts. Horror films, sex films are the same. You know, a sexy film 30 years ago would have a 30-second kiss in it. Now, people aren't interested in that because it's old hat. They want it more and more, you know, so things become more explicit.
Pushing the boundaries.
And as they become more explicit, people become more used to those. And so, to a certain extent, the film satisfies the person's urge for kicks, but it can only go so far. The film can only get so nasty.
All right.
And once it's got so nasty, then the people are going
to
go further for the kick.
Wants to comment on that?
Well, I tend to agree with the two men down the front here. I think it's all a matter of taste, really. If you want to watch a film, you'll watch it no matter what. And if you want your children to watch it, then that's entirely up to you. But, I mean, when I was a kid and I watched horror movies, it frightened me to death. But looking back now, yeah, you can tell. But now looking back on it, they're funny.
Yeah,
and I think children, I think, hold on a minute, you've had your say, let's have our say. Children nowadays look upon a movie now as a bit of fun. I've seen children watch horror movies and they laugh at them.
Well, what about, I mean, in Evil Dead 2, I mean, there's some shots of a woman being battered around the head with a post. I mean, is that fun?
Is that any worse than watching the news at 6 o'clock and somebody hitting somebody with a stick, hitting a policeman with a stick?
Yes.
That's what you've got to ask, isn't it?
For a start, it doesn't go on, for the news at 10 doesn't go, or whatever, news at 6
yes,
doesn't go
that's
on
real.
At quite the same time. But to a certain extent, yes, I would agree with you. Insofar as explicit violence is being shown on news at 6, I think, and it's a time when children are going to be watching the television,
that's
I think this
right.
is a reprehensible thing. And one of the interesting things, I mean, somebody mentioned Northern Ireland, one of the things, you've only got to go across there and talk to the people, especially talk to the police, talk to anyone over there who's had any experience of what's going on there, and you will find that people are inured to the violence. They have got used to it, and there are greater and greater levels of violence that have to occur before anything it causes.
I'll come back to one or two more on the front row in a moment, but let the lady right at the back and the far side have a say.
I agree. I don't agree with that guy over there that it's just for kicks. What it basically boils down to is that guy that writes about it and that guy that makes a profit out of it. And all this violence against women and all the blood and the gore is for profit. It's basically profit.
Well, Sam, presumably it is for profit. I mean, presumably you make it so that people actually pay to go and see it.
No, I make the pictures primarily to entertain the audience. That is my goal. And on Evil Dead, the motion picture.
Why don't you make it free viewing then?
On Evil Dead, the motion picture, I actually went into debt to be able to make that movie.
But you also said that to get investors, you first of all make them sick, and then they invest. I mean, that's the nature of your films. I mean, I don't want to stop you making films, my friend. I mean, if you want to make films like that, I mean, go ahead. What I think is really objectionable is to dress it up as entertainment. It isn't. I mean, this guy here is unquestionably entertained by it. But some of those scenes, we're not talking about the horror films of 30 or 40 years ago, which were removed from reality.
No, they were just as outrageous then as these are now.
Yeah, but showing these guys with blood vomiting out of the mouths, not of the puppets, the vomit out of the mouths of the actual actors, the live people, and the grotesque mutilations to their bodies. I mean, what do you not think? I mean, let me pose this question to you. Do you not think that an endless diet of that, or let's say a frequent diet of that, is not going to inure people to it, as Jamie Bogle said? Is it not going to inure people to it? And how much further are you going to have to go in Evil Dead 3? And how much further than that in Evil Dead 4?
Well, if there is an Evil Dead 3, I was thinking about bringing the Evil Dead to Britain, tell you the truth.
Hey, listen, bring it here.
Would you please take it back again?
You know, throughout the history of literature and entertainment, there has always been horrible acts of violence, from Shakespeare's Julius Caesar, his wife swallowing the hot coal. What I fear is that the repression, and Macbeth, of course, all the murders that took place. I'm a big fan of Shakespeare. What I'm worried about really is the repression of the arts, and that's really
this is a red herring. There's no question of repression of the arts.
All right, he's a little bit outnumbered tonight here. Would you like to respond to that on the front there?
Well, I mean, I'd just like to say that I must have seen thousands of people on videos and films being sort of chopped and mangled and minced, and I can tell you that there's absolutely nothing wrong with me.
I think the viewers at home decide that.
I told you it's like getting on a roller coaster.
Can
you go on for the
second? Can I just say
yes,
something?
Please
I was
do.
Involved in the previous situation on a more serious note. I've been involved in real-life horror, and believe me, that's far worse than anything you see on the screen.
Yes, but there's no parallel.
If you go around and speak to people in this audience or outside the studio, most of them will say, well, they believe they can decide for themselves what they want to see and what they don't want to see. I mean, I mean, quite honestly, I treat them as ludicrous because that's just what they are. To me, there is a certain amount of entertainment in it. But I think what we have to be concerned with here, because again, I have a further interest, I'm head of a school and I'm responsible for children. Now, at what stage would you honestly believe that a child can distinguish between what he sees on the screen as being fact and fantasy? And how does it influence him?
Well, I...
Now, can I ask you this question? Can you remember when you first became interested in this subject matter and at what level? Obviously,
yeah, I can,
obviously you've gained an appetite for it, and you would say to me, and I would agree with you, that you feel that you are quite capable of taking it. You're not going to go outside this studio. You know, if you were to see a film now, you're not going to go outside and perform the same act upon someone else.
Do you believe
all right,
me?
All right,
but
Ron,
I do. But what I would be concerned with is the availability of this material freely available.
Well, if you rent it from a video distributor, and I take it that is the main objection, that's the main argument. I mean, they do all have to have certificates now. You can't just if you're 10,
complete load of rubbish.
No, they're not. Well, because if you're 10 and you try and rent an 18 certificate.
Children of 10 don't.
Can I ask you something as a headmaster?
Yes.
When would you let your kids read Hansel and Gretel, which a witch tries to bake a couple of kids
well,
in an oven?
Well, Hansel and Gretel isn't. I mean, you're a little bit out of touch.
No, come on. That's all most horror movies are. Hansel and Gretel made into movies.
No. Coriolanus.
It's completely
different. Or Little Red
Riding
Hood. I mean, she's
a different medium.
After.
Look, if I could use some of the means that are used on video.
We're rapidly running short of time here. I just like the lady
in the... I would have a great deal more success. But are you saying to me, then, that there is absolutely no harm in them at all, and that young people are not...
No, what I'm saying is a parental responsibility.
Thanks very much indeed for that. Well, I was going to inform... Excuse me, Alan. Alan, thanks. So just a second. Sam, We're rapidly running short of time. We've brought you here from the States. Would you like just to sort of have a few final words about what you've heard this evening? I mean, are we ready for Evil Dead 2 here, do you think? Or indeed the making of Evil Dead 3 here?
Well, what I'd like to just say is that I know that there are no conclusive results of tests as to the effects of motion picture violence versus real violence. I know that there are still studies going on and that there have been never any conclusive results. I make pictures to entertain people, and horror movies are specifically designed to scare people. And possibly it's a good thing that you can sit in a theater and get your adrenaline pumping and scream and have a hooting good time. My movies are not realistic violence. I have walls bleeding orange, blue, black, yellow, and green paint. And I've got skulls that fly around and spirits that zoom about a cabin.
Right.
And it's it's kind of more surrealistic, I think, than a realistic portrayal of violence.
There's a lot of realistic
stuff
in there.
Well, I have to say that actually, come Friday night shortly on ITV, we will be having the Friday Nightmare, reviving all the old Hammer horrors, etc. And I hope you'll be able to tell the difference between that and Central Weekend, Sue.
Thank you very much indeed.